Hi, welcome back to ODE YouTube channel. Today we are here for another unboxing video. I want to make it kind of short. And as you can see, this is a pen mail from China. Comes with lots of plastic. And here I have my Victorinox Solo to open this package. And let's see what we have here inside. So, first part is out, and we have this protective thing. Let's cut here the top of it, and I think I will be able to extract the pen. And you can see it has a black end. There are many pens like that, so let me see if I can take it out. Yes, I can. And here you have it, nothing more. This one didn't come with that blue velvet thing. And here you can see this is a Jinhao Centennial. Another one. Yes, I already had one. Actually, more than one. But I had to have this one because it is yellow, and I guess by now you all know that I really like yellow pens. Okay, this one has a different nib from the usual. And let's just check it. So it has the medallion on top is golden colored. I think it's the first that I have like that, with the usual clip with the ball style, and then the rest is very Parker Dufault. And I think everyone would love to have a Parker Dufault in yellow, but they are very hard to find. They were just special edition, so we cannot really find them. Let me just show you something, and then I'll try. I'm telling you, I'm trying to keep this video short. I have several Parker Dufaults, and I also had several Jinhao Centennial. One of the Jinhao Centennials I have is this one. And this one is very similar to the current big red Parker Centennial. And this is a pen that is very similar, also with gold trim, but in this pen the end had this silver colored, and this one is golden to match the rest, which I think is a little bit nicer. The color is just good, and I think it could be a little bit more opaque because you can see the shadow of the section there. I don't know if you can see it in video, but I can see it in person. And if we uncap both pens, we can see the Jinhao nib has now changed, and this one had no indication of what size the nib was, but the new one clearly and very in a very big way it states that this is an F nib. Not that beautiful, that big F, but I think this is a nice pen. And now you may say, you are only buying fakes. No, these are not fakes, these are copies, very good copies. But I like the shape of the Parker Dufault. I already bought some time ago this one. This is the Ving Sung. I think it is the 670. Yes, 670. It is yellow, and I like yellow pens, as I told you, so I bought it. It is a little bit different. I think this one is nicer, but I like the opacity of the resin on that one better. But they are quite similar. But if you like the Parker feel, this one is more faithful to the style. Okay, so Now you will say, some of you will say, but you're trying to get, you're helping the market of not fake, but copy, with copies. Yes, somehow. But I have to say that I really like the design, and when I can afford, because there's a big price difference, I also buy these ones. And this is a real Parker Centennial Lufold. And this is amazing because it's very, very similar. However, yes, there will be another Chinese pen in the mail. I have one that I bought, didn't arrive yet, that is a copy of this one, a more perfect copy, because this one has the golden trim. There is one coming in the mail that has still has chrome trim, so more similar to this one, and it even has an engraving on the barrel. So it is something that I think it will be nice to show you. You can see the match of the colors is quite nice and it is fun. So I would like to have this one. Yeah, I think it was the Cloisonné or Cloisonné version. I would like to have it. I don't have it. This is my most yellow Parker Centennial Lufold I have, and I like this pen a lot. It is very beautiful, and this material is, this is amazing. I really think this is a very special material. I have another one in green. So just to show you, yes, I buy the replicas like this one or the Moonman M600, but I also buy the real stuff. But we have to see that I'm paying less than 15 euros for one of those, and I bought this one for more than 400 euros. So there is a big price difference between both. I don't think that Parker will stop selling these ones because people prefer to buy a 15 euro pen. I don't think so. If people buy this one, they will keep buying it because it is a Parker. But I have to say, these are quite nice, and it would be amazing if everyone used a pen like this. It would be a great thing, I think. So I will start talking about copies, replicas and fakes very soon here on the channel, but today it's okay, I'm showing pens that are replicas of others, but it's not about that. It's just about pens that I like and I got them, and soon I'll be making some more videos on that topic because I think it is interesting. And although I think some are copies, I have to say that I enjoy them, and if I enjoy them, I'll keep buying. So this is all I had to show you. Please leave your comments below, and I'll be back soon with some more videos. Bye.